Check.
Check one, two. Can this one go up at all? Check one. Check one, is it all the way up? Check one, two, check. Okay. Can you hear that, bro, here?
Yeah.
Mic check, testing 1-2, mic check, testing 1-2.
Check one, check.
1-2.
Check, 1-2, check.
Mm-hmm.
I need to go.
I need to go.
some testing.
You all to worship with us this morning. Listen, guys, we're getting ready to start in a few minutes. So on behalf of my pastor and I, we want to say thank you for streaming with us today. Love y'all.
Check, 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 one, two.
us fitly together. How many of you know that God is good and he still sits on the throne? So come on and let's put those blessed hands.
Lord, you are good and your mercy enduring forever.
Lord, you are good,
good and your mercy enduring forever.
Lord, you are.
y'all cars this morning, but I want y'all to put y'all this morning. Come on, y'all. Come on, family. Put your hands together. I'm so glad. Yeah, come on, y'all. Hey, children all lost our way. I'm so glad.
I'm so glad.
Yeah, yes, I am. A trouble don't last.
A great God this morning. Hallelujah. Sometimes everything don't seem good, don't seem well, but we know that God is yet good. Amen. And he's still in the blessing business. Hallelujah. He's a miracle worker. Yes, he is. Glory to God. I give him praise today. I worship him because of who he is.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He's a great God.
The splendor of a king, clothed in majesty. Let all the earth rejoice. Let all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light.
Shall be saved, amen.
Hallelujah.
Is that at the name of Jesus?
We praise you this morning.
Every knee
Good morning. Good morning. How many are glad that you serve a great God? If you serve a great God, would you honk at me? Let us hear you. Come on. Amen. Come on. Amen. Good morning, family. Good morning. It's so great to see so many of you all. We are so grateful. Before we start anything, can we give God praise for our pastor? Let's give God praise for Dr. Michael Lee Jackson. Come on. Let him hear. Yeah. Amen. We're so grateful. We can't thank God for him. We don't thank God for our first lady, Lady Barbara Jackson. Come on. Let's give God praise for her, too. Amen. Listen, family. Somebody felt that one. Listen, family, we're so grateful because we have some dedicated people that are part of our church who got here a whole hour before you got here and started setting up. Can you help me thank God for our team members who are serving faithfully? Come on. Let's thank God for our music ministry. Come on, let's show some love. Show some love. Yeah. Amen. Amen. Listen, we're going to go to God in prayer. How many believe that prayer changes things? Yeah. Listen, will you bow your heads right where you are? Bow your heads right where you are. Bow your heads right where you are. And we're going to go to God in prayer as a family. God, first of all, we say thank you for being so good. God, we thank you, God, that as bad as things are in our world, we realize it could be worse. Thank you for keeping your hand on us. Thank you for keeping your hand on our families. And for that, God, we just say thank you. Thank you, God, for all that you do. Thank you for the blessings that you do that we don't even pay attention to, God. Thank you for the car accident that didn't happen. Thank you for the job we didn't lose. Thank you for the house that didn't burn down. Thank you for the child that didn't go to jail. We thank you, God, for how you've kept us during this pandemic. Now, God, we say we need worship and word today, God. Bless our time together. And God, we'll be forever so careful, God, not to take the credit for what you do, God, because we know that it is not by power nor is it by might, but it's by your spirit. And God, you get the glory, God. And I'm praying even now that while we may be driving in today, that God, we know your spirit can meet us in our cars. Your spirit can meet us outside because you're not the God of the inside of the building, but you're the God of the entire world. And so, God, we're claiming victory right now. Lives are going to be changed. Souls are going to be touched. Some chains are going to be broken in the spirit in Jesus' name. We do pray. Everybody say amen. If you receive that, would you honk and there you go. Once again, thank you. Thank you. Once again, we're so grateful that you chose to worship with us today. Worship with us today. Listen, we're getting ready. We're getting ready to move on with service. But we would fellowship normally at this time. But what we want to do today, we want to do something more, a little bit more creative. If you are on any form of social media, would you honk at me, honk? Honk? Good. This is what I need you to do. I need you to take a selfie in your car. Take a selfie. We're going to give you a moment. Our musicians are going to play a little something. We're going to give you a little time. Take a selfie in your car. If you got a flip phone, it may take you a minute, but I promise you'll get it. Amen. Take a selfie in your car. Post it online. And use the hashtag #DriveInAtTheWELL. Drive in at the well. Yeah. Easy to love. Come on. While you're doing it, say the Jesus in me. The Jesus in you. Come on. The Jesus in me.
You're easy. So easy.
to Jesus.
Jesus in you.
Step to Jesus.
Jesus in me.
Come on.
Let the Jesus in you.
Yeah.
Sure, yeah.
Come on.
Sure, yeah.
Take a selfie. Take a selfie.
Jesus,
I say you're easy.
We're getting ready to press our way through our service. We're going to go ahead and get you out the heat. But there is a word from the Lord. But right before the word comes, we're going to receive another selection from our choir, our praise ensemble. Amen. Would you give them a hand or a hunk? I'm sorry. Give them a hunk. Can't say hand no more. Yeah. Amen. Listen, right before they come, we're going to ask again, make sure everybody stay in your car as much as you can. But also, if you have not received the packet, which you should have, would you hunk so our service members can go ahead and make sure you're served? If you have not received your packet, if you have not received your packet with your communion cup as well as your offered envelope, would you hunk so they'll come to you and serve you expeditiously? Come on, let's bless us.
Worthy.
He's 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 worthy.
Let's sing it to him.
Praise him.
Come on, help us sing.
Praise him. Praise him. Praise him.
Say, Jesus, Jesus.
Jesus.
Blessed Savior.
Blessed Savior.
I wish you would help me sing it in your car. Let's sing it one more time. Praise him.
Praise him.
Everybody say
praise him.
Yeah. Say
praise him.
Oh.
Praise him.
Say Jesus.
Jesus.
Let's stay down. Just say Jesus.
Jesus.
Say Jesus. Jesus.
Jesus.
I wish you would help me sing right where you are. Thank you so much, brothers and sisters, for your presence today. God has a word for us today. God has a word for us today. If you have your Bibles, if you have your Bibles, if you have your Bibles, I want you to go to Psalm 103. Psalm 103. Yeah, if you can tap with me or turn with me, as my pastor says. Tap with me or turn with me to Psalm 103, verse number 1, for our consideration this morning. Amen. Psalm 103, verse number 1 says like this. It says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Let me read that again. It says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that's within me. Bless his holy name. I want to talk very simply from this thought, brothers and sisters. My praise is essential. I want to talk about my praise is essential. One of the buzzwords, brothers and sisters, in 2020 has been the term essential. It means absolutely necessary or extremely important. The question is, for the child of God who is living through this pandemic, the reminders of injustices because of the color of our skin, what then is essential for the child of God? All right. I want to suggest to you, brothers and sisters, that your praise is essential. Yeah. That your ability to find a place in your pain, yeah, to give God glory despite what's going on around you. Can I tell you, brothers and sisters, that whatever you do during this season, don't you leave home without your praise. Because I want to suggest to you, when you got a real praise, you don't need to be in a building to give God glory. But I want to suggest that you can give God praise even while you're riding to work. Even when you're in the shower by yourself, and you can have a flashback of how good your God is. Your praise is essential. Brothers and sisters, can I tell you, when you look at this text in a cursory way, you would think that David is talking to others in this text. For he says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that's within me, bless his holy name. But when you really have a clear understanding of Psalm 103, verse number 1, you'll discover that David is not talking to other people. David is talking to himself. How do you know that, Pastor Trey? Well, look at the personal pronouns in this verse. It says, bless the Lord, O my soul. And it says, and all that is within me. What David is saying, he says, sometimes when you're praising, you have to make yourself praise. He says sometimes that as much as you love God, sometimes you've got to talk yourself into giving God glory. That's simply because, brothers and sisters, life sometimes gives us reasons not to praise God. But can I tell you, brothers and sisters, as bad as things are, let me announce to you again that God is still good. I said God is still good. Can I tell you, brothers and sisters, I was wondering, because this is what you call a personal psalm. This is a psalm that comes from a personal place of David. And I was wondering, why in the world would David write this personal psalm for himself? One thought is that when you look at Psalm number 102, Psalm 102 is talking about a fervent prayer that he's praying to God because he's going through. But what some scholars have suggested, that the reason why David's praise is so personal is because God had answered the prayer in the previous psalm. And because of what God had already done in another chapter, he can praise him in the current chapter. I'm wondering, is there anybody around here that's ever had some prayers that God answered in a previous chapter? And the reason why you can trust him during the pandemic, because this ain't the first time he's had to bless you when you couldn't go to work. This ain't the first time he had to pay your bills and keep food on your table. That's simply because God has a way of answering prayers and letting you know he still answers prayers. But others suggest, Pastor, that the reason why this psalm is so personal for David is because David is now sitting at the end of his kingship. And now David recognizes that when he looks back over his life, he has a testimony of what God has done for him all through his life. Every now and then, brothers and sisters, you got to have what they call flashbacks. You ought to have some moments where you go back in your life and refer back to all the times God made a way, all the time God paid your bills, all the times. Can I tell you, sometimes you got to look back. That's what the song says, when I think of the goodness of Jesus. The reason why it says that is because he's been good before. And if he's been good, I wish y'all, go ahead. I'm not afraid of you today. Would you go ahead and hug him and say, he's still good? I love this. I love this, brothers and sisters. I love this because the text says something that shocks me. It says, bless. In the Hebrew, that word literally means to kneel. Now, you must understand, there are other words that are going on in the Hebrew language that refer to our English word, praise. There are some forms that talk about lifting your hands. There are others that are talking about doing a dance. But this form talks about kneeling. That's simply suggesting, brothers and sisters, that when you give God glory, it's not so much about how high you jump, it's about how straight you choose to walk. I wish I had some help right there. Because can I tell you something? You're not ready to praise God until you're willing to submit to him. And can I tell you, your submission to God starts when God is doing stuff that you don't want him to. Can I tell you something? That anybody can give God glory when all the bills are paid and everything's good at the house. But God wants to know, can you still worship me even when you disagree with what I'm doing? I love this also because you'll discover that the word blessed there has another meaning. It also means to bless oneself. What David is trying to suggest is that whenever you learn how to really praise God, your praise will make you feel better. Is there anybody here that's ever had that testimony? That it seemed like you came to church with your head down. You came to church with a heavy heart. But as soon as the music started going, as soon as the message started going, that seemed like that burden that was on your heart already got lifted. It's only because you have the same testimony, that simply that the more that I praise him, the better that I feel. Is there anybody here testimony today that you can say worship makes me feel better? Now listen, let's not move too fast, Pastor. Notice that this is a king who's writing this text, and the king who is the king and the leader of the most powerful nation on earth at this time, he says that I need to praise my God by kneeling to him. Get this. He kneels to God. Y'all missing the shout. The most powerful person of the most powerful nation, he's not standing in God's presence. He's kneeling. Y'all don't know when to get happy. I'll say it again. The most powerful person on earth, he's not standing in front of a church opposing with a Bible, but what he's doing, he's kneeling. See, that's the problem with the leadership we have in our country, because he's trying to stand holding up a Bible in front of the church, when the truth is, don't hold up a Bible if you can't hold up what the Bible teaches. And the Bible teaches that the poor will be among you always, and what you do to the least of these, you've done to me. And so this king says that it's just not enough to praise him in front of the camera, but I got to praise him on my knees. Wish I had some help right there. I love this. I love this because, brothers and sisters, it says, bless the Lord. It shout me. I'm trying to move past that word. Lord, it means self-existing one. It literally means that this is the God of all gods. It literally means that God doesn't have a birthday and he doesn't have a death day, because God always was. That simply means that God cannot be voted out and he cannot be voted in. Can I tell you, you serve a God who created everything, and because he created everything, he's the most powerful God. I love this, brothers and sisters. I love this because this what shocks me is that in this text, it says, he says, bless the Lord, oh, my soul. That's the most purest part of David that he can offer God. That I've got to bless him from my soul. I know that this is a soul praise, because when you look at Psalm 103, you'll discover that there is no request for God to do anything for him. Don't miss that. There is no request of him to move enemies or bless him in any way. Because when I discover, when you start praising God from your soul, you don't go to God asking him for what he can do for you, but you learn how to go to God and thank him for what he's already done for you. Because David says that when I'm giving God glory from my soul, it's not about what he's going to do, it's about what he's already done. But I love this. I love this, brothers and sisters. He says, and all that is within me. Notice David says, it's not just enough for me to praise him from my soul, but everything that's within me. He says, there's no part of who I am that I won't use to give God praise. Can I tell you something? I know that may seem like a high price to pay, but I want you to think about it. That if you're going to give God your all, I want you to think about all that God has done for you. Because the truth is, somebody will say, it don't take all of that, Pastor Clay. Well, what if God sent us bills based on what he did for us? Every breath you took, every day that you've given, God says, you owe me your all because of what I've done for you. I love that, brothers and sisters. I love that. because when I was, me and Pop, we were looking at The Last Dance, this documentary on the Chicago Bulls, and I noticed something. That was a game where Michael Jordan actually had food poison. And he had food poisoning, and he chose to still play for the Bulls, even though he was sick. And as the documentary went on, there's a vivid picture of Scottie Pippen carrying Michael Jordan off of the court because he was so sick. And a reporter asked him, couldn't you find somebody else to do? Couldn't you find somebody else to carry Jordan off of the floor? Surely that's some manager, that's some other team members that could have carried him across. And Scottie Pippen sat back on the reporter and he simply said, it's easy for me to carry him off because he's been carrying us. Can I tell you something? The reason why you owe God praise is because God has been carrying you everywhere. I wish I had some help right there. That God has been carrying you every step of the way. Because when you give God your all, when you give God your all, I'm trying to hold my peace, I promise. But when you give God your all, you decide that whether my neighbor is shouting or not, I'm going to give God glory by myself. Because what I discovered that when you decide to give God your all, you simply have this one testimony that if he doesn't do anything else, he's been good enough so I can praise him for the rest of my life. I'm almost done, brothers and sisters. I got only a few words left. It says, bless the Lord, oh my soul. And all that's within me. Here's the last words. It says, bless his holy name. I said again, it says, bless his holy name. The word holy there means to be set apart. What David is saying, he said that the name of God, it's so awesome, it's set apart from any other God. Can I tell you, there's no greater God than the God that we serve. That's why the choir, that's why our ensemble just got through singing, how great is our God. How many know that you serve a great God? I love this. I love this because the Bible says, bless his holy. His holy name. I knew I was preaching to you. This is my first time preaching outside and in basketball shorts. And I knew I had to do come correct and do my homework. And what I discovered, brothers and sisters, is the word name in this text literally means the express character or reputation of God. It simply means that God has different characteristics. And all of his characteristics are determined by different names. And each name is a different snapshot of what God can do in the life of his people. Y'all looking at me funny. Let me see. Can I come down your street? Can I tell you now? Here's the truth. Back in Georgia, in my family, I had a few nicknames. My late grandmother calls me her twin. That's because I act just like her, look just like her. My grandfather used to call me Spody Rody. That's because everywhere he went, I wanted to go. My auntie, she calls me Hubba Bubba. That's because, now don't call me that, I'm still Pastor Trey. I gotta say that because I know how we are. She calls me Hubba Bubba because as a little boy, every time I saw her, I asked her, did she have a piece of Hubba Bubba bubble gum? All right, now, understand this. I got different names from different people. And all of the names mean something different. To my grandmother, twin means I look like it and I act like her. To my aunt, Hubba Bubba is a sign that I always ask for bubble gum. Yeah. And then my grandfather called me Spody Rody because I always was on his heels. Yeah. Now notice I got three different names, but each name describes who I am to everybody I know. Let me see, can I come down your street? Can I tell you, you serve a God who has a few nicknames. And every nickname that God has goes to something that that you know God can do. Now, what I need you to do, this is the crowd participation part of the message. And what I need you to do, I'm going to call a few of God's nicknames. And what I need you to do, if I call them by a nickname that you know them by, I need you to honk at your boy and let me know I know that name. Will y'all help me today? I said, will y'all help me today? There you go. Here it is. Here's the first name. It's Jehovah Shalom. That's the God of all peace. If you ever had trouble in your life, but instead of blowing your brains out and giving up, you still stayed in that thing, that's only a sign that God knows how to give you peace. Let me hear the people that know him by that name. Maybe you don't know him by Jehovah Shalom, but maybe you know him by Jehovah Jireh. That's the God who provides. If you've ever been down to your last dime, and you did not know where your next meal was coming from, somebody ought to testify that I hadn't missed a meal during the pandemic. It's because God is a provider. Let me hear the people that say God is a provider. Maybe you can say, I don't know about Jehovah Jireh, but maybe you know Jehovah Rapha. That is the God who heals you. Maybe you've been sick in your body, and the doctor said he couldn't do anything else from you. But look at you 5 years later, and you're still looking like you're looking. Because it's a sign that God knows how to heal you. See, some of y'all ain't gonna shout right there, because maybe you ain't been sick, but you have had a broken heart. You had people to hurt you, but look at you still smiling. It's because God knows how to heal your heart. Maybe you don't know about those names. What about Waymaker? Wait, what about Bridge Over Troubled Waters? What about a doctor and a lawyer? I wish I had somebody here. Lord, I'm trying not to turn this corner, Pastor, but my blinker light is on. But is there anybody here that can testify today that I know that name? I've got to get out of here now. I said, I've got to get out of here now. But I got one more name to tell you. And that name is Emmanuel, which simply means God who is with us. What you mean he's with us? Why do you think we're still here during a pandemic? And over 100,000 people have already died. It ain't because of your mask. It ain't because of your gloves. It ain't because of your sanitation. But if it had not been for the Lord who was on your side, said, tell me, where would I be? As a matter of fact, there is a name that I love to hear, and I love to sing his word. It sounds like music in my ear, the sweetest name on earth. Ah, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. I said, because he first. I didn't mean to go here, but y'all got to excuse me. But I ain't preached in front of you in a couple of months, so I got to say it one more time. Would you help me preach it? And look at somebody as a neighbor. Say, neighbor, I believe that church is over, and I'll see y'all when I see you. Peace. But if you don't see me again, what you know about Jesus? He's all right. I said he's all right. I said he's all right. I said he's all right. Say yes. Honk yes. I said honk yes. Say yes. Yes. Say yes. I got to get out of here. But what, is there anybody on the field that can take about 5 seconds to give God praise in your car? That you can say, I know that name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If it had not been for the Lord, can I tell you? Child of God, your praise is essential. Don't you lose your praise. I know times are hard, But don't you lose your praise. I know your family may feel like it's falling apart, but can I tell you, he's been keeping it together. And when you think it's all over, God already has another move. If you receive this word, would you honk at me? You receive this word. Hallelujah. Listen, we're going to open. We don't want to take for granted that just because you drove out here, that everybody's saved. I can't think of a better time than right now, a better day than today, to give your life to Christ. If you need to give your life to Christ, would you stick your arm out of your car, and we're coming to you. If it had not been for the Lord on my side, tell me where. Bless you, baby. Come on. Say, tell me where. Come on. From the top. Say, if it had. Give God glory. Were you blessed today? Were you blessed by the word? Hallelujah. 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 We're so grateful. So grateful. So grateful. Amen. You all showed out again. You showed up in great numbers. So give yourselves a hand. Give yourselves a hand. Yeah. Give yourselves a hunk. I'm sorry. Yeah. Yeah. Listen, we're getting ready to give now. We're getting ready to give. Getting ready to give. When I ask again, has everybody received a packet with your offering envelope and your communion cup? If you have not, would you honk until somebody comes to you? Honk until somebody comes to you. Honk until somebody comes to you. Amen. That's the best silence I ever heard right there. Amen. Amen. Good. Amen. 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 One more time, would you help me thank God for our servers? The team members, amen. Go ahead and make your offering envelopes out. Go ahead and make those out. If you want to give to benevolence, if you want to give to Sunday school, there are slots, there are places on the envelope. Just fill it out, earmark it for that particular fund, and we'll make sure it gets there. So go ahead and take time now. Listen, I'll be remiss if I didn't thank God for the hardworking people who are helping us stream online, our worship team, our musicians, Reverend Faust is helping us and preach, Pastor Jackson. Come on, can we thank God for a church that's continuing to serve? Come on, y'all need to do better than that. Yeah. Yeah, we thank God. We thank God for our team that's coming. Amen. Listen, would you go ahead, if you already filled that out, would you hold that up, put it back in the bag, amen, put it back in the bag, this is for your safety and ours, put it back in the bag, all right, And listen, don't be in a rush. We're gonna do communion in a moment. We're gonna let you go. Listen, take that gift, hold it up, 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 hold it up. Yeah, there you go. Hold it up. Hold it up. And repeat after me right where you are. Say, Lord, thank you. Say it like you mean it. Say, Lord, thank you for another opportunity to give back to you a portion of what you've given to me. Our servers are coming right now. They already started. They're coming right now to serve you and get your offerings from you. Go ahead, and once you give your offerings, go ahead and get ready. We're going right into communion. We're going right into communion. Right into communion as a family. Amen. Soon as you give, soon as you give. Forever and ever and ever. For all, come on, you've done, come on, for me. Blessing and glory
and honor,
they
all belong to you.
Say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus, for me.
Come on, help me sing it, you right where you are. Say, I just want to thank you.
Just want to thank you.
Yeah.
Before we move into the communion, we have some of our members use oil to anoint people and pray. And they ask us if we will bless this oil today. They're going to be using it in their homes and in their community. So let's just turn to God for a minute. Our Father and our God, we know that this is just oil. but for his symbolism, his representation of your spirit and your presence. We ask your blessing upon it. May those that be anointed with it feel your presence in their life. We pray, oh God, for healing. We pray for comfort. We pray for protection. We pray for your blessing on this. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Have everyone been served? Does anybody need to be served? If anybody need to be served, just reach your hand out the window, blow your horn, and we'll bring it to you. Communion at this time. At this time, 2,000 years ago, Jesus met with his disciples in the upper room. They had just finished the Passover meal. And when they finished the Passover meal, he introduced a new supper.